What is a leverage ratio? Let's use a housing example to break it down. Say you're buying a home that costs $100,000. When you put money down on a house, that creates a kind of protective cushion. Now, the difference between the value of the house and the unpaid amount of the mortgage, that's called owner's equity. So now, when you first buy a house, your down payment is your owner's equity. Over time, as you pay down your mortgage, and if your home value goes up, well, that means your owner's equity rises, which makes the protective cushion bigger. The ratio of debt to equity, which represents how much of a protective cushion is in a home, that's called the leverage ratio. So, a 5% down payment on a $100,000 home would mean you'd have $5,000 in owner's equity, which, when compared to the mortgage of $95,000, would give you a leverage ratio of 19. And as you pay off more of your mortgage, assuming the value of your home stays constant, your leverage ratio will fall. So what's the effect of high leverage? It means that there's very little room for the price on your home to drop before the value of your house is less than the unpaid mortgage amount. That is, if you needed to sell your home to pay off your mortgage, the proceeds from the house sale would not be enough to pay off the bank. Being underwater is clearly not good for the individual homeowner, but very importantly, it's also not good for the bank. In the case of foreclosure, say the homeowner cannot keep on paying the mortgage. Well, the bank is going to get a home, but the home isn't worth enough. The bank loses money because the value of the home is less than what the bank was expecting to receive from the homeowner in the form of mortgage payments. However, a high leverage ratio is not just a problem in the housing sector. Take the investment bank, Lehman Brothers, in 2004. It had a leverage ratio of about 20, but it continued to borrow more money. And by 2007, that leverage ratio went as high as 44. So when Lehman Brothers' assets fell in value very quickly in 2008, they were underwater. That is, their assets were worth less than the debt that they owed, and the company was insolvent. So leverage ratio is important because it measures how leveraged a company is, and in the case of Lehman, highly. And a company's degree of leverage, high versus low, translates directly into a measurement of risk for the shareholders. To learn more about the failure of financial intermediaries such as Lehman, click here. Or to test your knowledge on leverage ratios, click here. Still here? Check out Marginal Revolution University's other popular videos.